The world of mountain biking is a funny thing. It seems to be the only sport in which people think they can buy performance. Ranked amateurs think by spending lots of money on a bike they're going to be good at it, or at least have the performance of someone that's good at it. But the truth is, it's mainly the rider. So with that in mind, what is arguably the biggest false economy? Buying expensive pro-level gear? Or buying the cheapest stem you can find on Amazon and AliExpress? I've seen this for $5 with free delivery. I've seen it for £3.50 in the UK with free delivery. Interestingly, from Amazon DE, it's a bit more expensive. It's about €10. And due to the chunkiness and design of the stem, I actually feel quite confident with this one, but I wouldn't feel so confident with, like, let's say, cheaper handlebars. But should you buy it? Okay, so there's three disadvantages to buying this stem. One is that the nuts do not have Loctite or anti-slip washers. Both of those can be easily fixed. And thirdly, it's quite a small stem height-wise, so if at a later point you wanted to buy a more professional stem and you've cut down the head of your fork, then that's going to be a problem. Which is why I haven't committed to cutting down the head of my fork yet. So you'll see that spaces for the headset sit way above the stem at the moment. So should you buy it? Absolutely. Look, I'm a big guy. I've tried to break this thing. I can't. I've put so much weight on it. I've done jumps. I've purposely gone out to find trails that are like pure rock. And I don't mean kind of rock gardens. I mean loose rock. So it's permanently jumping me about. I can't shake these things loose, and I haven't put any Loctite or got the anti-slip washers yet, which I will do eventually. Look. If you're on a budget or you're not a professional, then it's great. The only other disadvantage is people might look down your nose at you at the old bike park, but that's not something that concerns me at all. No real disadvantages. You get all the performance of a high-end part for next to nothing of the money. It's a good starting modification. I would say, though, because it is small in height, you will need headset spaces as well, so factoring headset spaces in the price when you're buying this is highly unlikely that you're just going to get away with spending $5. You're going to have to buy headset spaces as well, which I found was super cheap in my local bike shop when compared to online when you brought a whole set. So for those of you wondering, my previous stem was a 100mm stem. This one's a 35mm stem. The performance is night and day. The additional control at high speeds going downhill has given me so much more confidence now with this 35mm stem. And even if you don't end up buying the wake stem, then definitely the shorter stem is good. I've heard disadvantages. This is just general 35mm stem talk now. I've heard there can be a disadvantage when going uphill that you can pull wheelies. I didn't really experience that. There was one time when I was on a real steep incline and there was lots of roots sticking out, and I did find it really easy to bring the front wheel up just to get over a particularly high root. So that was my only experience of this. Much easier to pull the bars up, but I didn't find myself naturally pulling the bars up and sort of wheeling up a hill or anything like that. So actually, it's given me confidence. I'm much quicker downhill. I'm much more confident on the bike. I can steer on a penny, and I definitely recommend going to a much smaller stem length.